my three favorite jig poles and some of the guys that I fish with that helped me become a better jig fisherman by learning the ins and outs and just, again, fishing with different people and getting different opinions and techniques and stuff, but with the same common denominator, and that is catching crappie with one rod in your hand, single poling, in anything that they sit in. Number one, you know it. This little baby right here is called the Sam Super Sensitive. Okay, it comes in 10, 11, and 12 foot lengths. With this one, it has the bottom seat. See how that is there? So the reel's at the very back, totally out of my way, doesn't get anything, and it really helps the balance of the rod. It makes the rod feel a lot lighter and stuff too, okay? And it has that thing right there. See that? That's called the touch system. And what happens is the blank's going right through the cork handle, so I can feel those real sensitive bites. Hence the name, Sam's Super Sensitive. Killer rod, man. I use this a lot in the 12-foot lengths when I'm fishing more open water and pads and different things. And I'm not too worried about getting stuck up in heavy brush like I would if I was on, let's say, Lake Conway or somewhere right inside that real heavy brush, where it can be a real challenge to learn how to put your rod in, pull the jig up to the tip of the pole, put it in, and then drop it. You know, my buddy Jeff Smith from Crappie Magnet showed me how to do that, and John Godwin and Jay Stone over in Louisiana. There's a definite technique, no matter where you fish for crappie, but that Sam Super Sensitive, killer rod, man. Number two on my list is the original. 30 years ago, B&M came out with that BGJP. This is the 10-2N. And yeah, I'm reading it, you know, because who's going to remember all this kind of stuff? This is the actual model number, okay? This, the 10-footer, retails for about, oh, $50, $49.99, depends where you are in the States and stuff. And this comes in 8, 10, 12, 14, and 16-foot lengths for those guys that spider rig a lot. But for me, that 10, 11, and 12 just seems just perfect, okay? They've enlarged the guides as well, too, for more versatility from your bobby fishing and stuff like that, too. And the reel seat, redesigned as well, keep it closer to the pole, and it's got that real nice black matte finish. I really like that, don't you? Cool looking little rod, eh? But again, just another option. And last but not least, this is the one that that legendary guy in Mississippi, John Harrison, he uses this. See that right there? It's called Ultra-LITE, and it's spelled L-I-T-E, okay? For those that want to look for it. This one right here, the model number is BBULBS10. Because I like the 10-footer when I'm vertical jigging over brush piles and things like that. I could be in Crab Orchard Lake or in Kincaid and stuff with Luke and Chopper and those guys. This one retails across the States for like $55. It comes in 10, 11, and 12-foot lengths. And easily, one of the most lightest, most sensitive jig poles on the market. Now, I know you're going to say that's a bold statement, but I'm a bold man. So I'm saying this is it right here. And if John Harrison uses it, I'm going to be using it. But I mean, think about it. Look at the touch system. Again, right there. See that little right there? I can fish that. And the way the reel seat is at the back here like that. Do you see that? It's called bottom seat. Way at the back. It's so light. I can jig all day and not even think about it. And that's the key. You got to be focusing on what you're doing. That little 1/32nd, 1/16th, 1/8 ounce jig. And you know you're putting it in sometimes some nasty stuff where those bigger crappie are, and you got to feel those real sensitive sensations, okay? Sometimes they're not even bites, it's a sensation. That ultralight rod and the Bucks Graphite and the Sam Super Sensitive are going to help you feel those bites. Now, we all know when crappie are aggressive, everyone can catch them any which way but loose. Crankbaits, little spinner baits, tube jigs, underfloats, every which way under the rainbow. But it's when they're sensitive, when you gotta hunt them down, man, one-on-one, one pole in your hand, getting in that nasty stuff. It's very reminiscent of bass fishing, and that's why I probably really love it. Because my, you know, bass and me, born to fish for bass. But crappie, it fills that void for me all the time, because I can fish them in early spring, late fall, when sometimes the bass bite can be iffy, and depending where I am, what states, what the seasons are, and stuff like that. But crappie, and even up here in Ontario during the winter, all winter long they bite. They're such a vicious little critter, you know? If they were like in the 5, 6, and 7 pound range, I don't think we'd even land them. With that paper mouth and stuff, you know, nature made them perfect. They taste good, they fight nice, they school up, and just everybody loves to fish for crappie, right? You're with me, let's all agree on that. Okay, but this one here, the Ultra-LITE, I think it retails for about $55, but I'm telling you, it's the best money spent. You pick up this, you may never pick up another jig pole or buy another one in your life. Again, bold statement, but I know it works. Visit bnmpoles.com, and the little reel seat, I'm going to show you that. See that right there? Now, this little thing is called the Bucks Ultra-LITE Graphite Reel, and this little thing here retails for about $17.99. You might say to yourself, man, it doesn't hold much line. All it does is hold enough line that I can pull out, strip a little bit of line out, because all I'm doing is just fishing right in front of me. And with the 10-foot pole and 10 feet down, let's say all the way down to here, that's 20 feet that I have to fish in front of the boat, down a boat. If I want to fish a bit further away from me, the 11-foot, 12-foot, again, it'd add me like 22 feet up to 24 feet of distance away from those crappie. So single pole jig fishing is addictive. Once you do it, it's unreal, man. But two things you got to consider. A proper anchor system or the power poles and stuff where you can sit on the spot, because it really is an art. Sometimes you're jigging it and moving it and stuff like that, you know, you're taking your time. But a lot of times, some of those guys who shown me, I put the jig in and my line, it's just a twitch. That's it. Nothing. They just leave it. And know those crappie come up to it, they're going to look at it and then you blink and you'd miss it. That's how fast they can hit it. But again, with a little sensation coming through the blank like that, you'll feel those little bites by keeping your finger on it. Now, there were just different ways that those guys showed me how to do it. I'm not an expert, but I love to fish crappie. I love to fish for them anyway, and always learning with these top guys. And I'll tell you what, it wouldn't be right talking about jig fishing without mentioning some of the guys I fish with who are really good. Number one on the list, and it's only, you know, not alphabetical or anything, but John Harrison. We all know, man, in Mississippi, this guy is a legend. He guides sometimes for months at a time. And what does he do a lot? He picks up that Ultra-LITE. And he finds that stuff out of the way on those 4 or 5 lakes, Enid, Sardis, you know, Grenada. He knows where to find those crappie, and he just keeps going at it with milk runs and milk runs. A couple other guys that I fish with in Louisiana, on Darbonne, in those deep cypress and stuff, Mr. Jay Stone and John Godwin. These guys, again, they figured out how to do it, man. They find the right things, similar root patterns and stuff, and a lot of times they don't just run up to the tree. They see where the branches come out, and they fish those outer edges and stuff too, where a lot of guys are fishing right against the stem of a tree. They're out about 5, 6 feet on the root systems. Jeff Smith from Crappie Magnet, that guy showed me so much fishing with him with a couple of years on Lake Conway. And he, man, in Arkansas, he's got one of the biggest networks. He's a great fisherman and a great guy. But man, he showed me a lot of things, opened up my eyes when jig fishing in heavy forests and stuff on like Lake Conway. George Nealon in Texas, the guy's amazing, man. He fishes those lakes there. We fish little creeks sometimes when it was flooded. Just the different techniques was phenomenal. Another guy in Tennessee, Jackie Wayne Van Cleve. The guy started guiding when he was 13 years old. So think about it. He's had jig poles in his hand his whole life. And another guy that I'm going to be fishing with, and I've always wanted to, is Whitey Outlaw. Think about it. Whitey Outlaw, Van Cleve, Jay Stone, John Godwin. It sounds like a spaghetti western, man, with these outlaws and stuff like that. But that's what those crappie fishermen are. They're great guys. Great characters. And that's what makes fishing for me a lot more fun when I'm with these kind of guys. But there's one more guy that I got to mention that is legend in Tennessee, and it's Dude Maddox. Think of that. You couldn't script a name like that if you tried. Dude Maddox. Jeff Smith and a lot of guys put me onto this guy. So dude, if you hear about this, you see this, let's get in touch, my friend. Let's fish for those big Tennessee, Nashville area crappies. Where you catch them, I heard, 30, 40 days straight when you're living out. I want to do that with you. So let's just remember, jig pole fishing is just another way to catch crappie. Once you do it, you'll get addicted like me.